Well, 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 here's Mama Bloom's brood. Sunday morning in the Bloom household. Mama and Papa have just finished breakfast. Mama is clearing away the dishes, and Papa is reading his paper. But he seems to be perturbed about something.
Mama, Mama, why don't you wake them up?
Let them sleep.
It's after 12. Are they going to sleep all day?
What's the difference, Jake? It's Sunday. They don't have to go to work. Let them sleep.
Just because it's Sunday, do they have to sleep all day?
What difference does it make to you?
Why do you have to make breakfast 10 times?
In the first place, I only have to make breakfast 2 times. And in the second place, maybe I like making breakfast.
Make them get up and eat breakfast when I do. It wouldn't kill them. A second breakfast is a terrible bother.
What bother can it be to you if I cook the breakfast?
Is this a restaurant where anybody can have breakfast whenever they want it?
Look, Jake, the store's your business. The house is my business. You run your department and I'll run my department.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mama, what time did they get in last night?
To tell you the truth, I don't know.
How can you not know? In the bedroom was a clock, ain't it?
I didn't look at the clock.
Didn't you hear them come in?
Jake, you know never in my life did I go to sleep before the girls come in.
Uh-huh. Then you must know what time they came in.
Jake, I'll tell you a secret.
Yeah?
If they come in late, I know the next morning you're going to ask me what time did they come in.
Yeah?
And so that I shouldn't have to tell you a lie, I make it my business not to look at the clock.
And then what?
Then when you ask me, I can tell you I don't know.
Oh, Mama. Mama, where can they stay out so late?
How do I know? When you take me out, you always bring me home at 11:30. So what goes on after that, I wouldn't know.
Was Sarah out with him?
Well.
Is she going to marry him?
How should I know? Today, everything is different. In our day, Jake, a girl who went with a man as long as Sarah's been going to Sydney would already be married to him and have 2 children.
Yeah, but do you think she's going to marry him?
She didn't tell me nothing.
Don't she ever ask you anything?
No. A girl used to come to her mother for advice, and now she writes to a newspaper.
Mm. Tell me, has he got any money?
To tell you the truth, Jake, I didn't search him.
But he's got a job, ain't he?
Usually he's got a job. Right now he's tired, so he's resting.
Tired? Tired? What's he tired for?
He didn't tell me.
That's all I need. A son-in-law who's always tired.
Don't get yourself aggravated, Jake. He still ain't your son-in-law. And he'll get a job. He can always get a job. Last month he had 3.
3 jobs in 1 month? What's the matter with the jobs? No good?
Sarah said they didn't fit his personality.
Personality? Personality? What does that mean?
How should I know? Am I a college professor?
And another thing, Becky. I'm telling you, if Sarah and Yetta come into breakfast in pajamas, I won't stand for it. Pajamas you sleep in, not heat in.
What difference does it make to you what they wear?
I will not stand for pajamas. Do I wear pajamas to breakfast?
What are you fighting with me this morning for? Fighting is bad for you. It hardens the artillery.
All right, artilleries are smellies. Right, wake up the girls.
Right.
Wake up the girls.
If it'll make you any happier, I'll wake them up.
And if it'll make you any happier, let them sleep.
No, I'll wake them up. It's time they got up anyhow. Sally! Yvette! It's almost 1 o'clock. Get up.
Mm-hmm. Do you think they'll pay any attention to you?
Sure they'll pay attention to me.
They will. Well, why don't they get up then?
Maybe they didn't hear me.
No, why don't you speak louder?
You want I should yell at them? What are my daughters, streetcars?
I am not asking you to yell. I am only asking you to holler.
What is the difference? A holler is a yell and a yell is a holler.
Uh-huh. You're telling me English. What am I, a greenhorn?
What are you doing now, Jake? Hollering or yelling?
What difference is it?
You see, I told you. A holler is a yell.
All right. Have it your way. But meanwhile, they are not getting up.
If they can sleep at you hollering or yelling, they must be tired.
Mama, are you going to ask them to get up?
Didn't I already told them?
Yeah, but how loud did you told them?
How can I measure how loud I told them?
For the last time, Mama, are they going to sleep all day?
For the last time after the last time, I don't know.
Mama, I'm too tired to argue with you.
Yeah, and they're too tired to get up.
If I am tired, it makes no difference. But if they are tired, then it makes a difference.
You're tired, so they should get up.
What did they do last night? They should be so tired.
Jake, already I told you 7 times Sarah was with Sidney.
Mm-hmm. And 8 times I have answered you I don't like it.
Jake.
Yeah, what is it?
Jake, tell me, what's worrying you?
Worrying me? Nothing, Mama.
Something is worrying you. Why do you act like this?
Act like what?
I don't know what you act like. I just know something's on your mind.
Becky, you can always tell.
Well, what is it?
Becky, Sam and I are having arguments.
Sam, your partner?
Partner? He's my partner up to now.
You're not splitting up with Sam?
Oh, no, Mama, I am not splitting. Sam is splitting.
Well, why is he splitting?
Why? I don't know.
So that's what's worrying you?
Yes, Mama, that's what it is.
Well, since when did this happen?
Maybe 4 weeks, maybe 5.
Why didn't you tell me, Jake?
But, Mama, why should I tell
you? Am I a stranger?
No, you're not a stranger, but...
If you're sick, you tell me. Why don't you tell me if the business is sick?
But what good would it do telling you?
Can't I worry a little bit, too?
All right. I told you, so what?
What did you argue about?
Nothing.
Nothing?
No, nothing at all.
How can you argue about nothing at all? You and Sam aren't married.
Well, Mama, it's like this.
Mm-hmm. Now it comes up.
You know, when Sam and I started in business, we each put up the same amount of money, you remember?
Yes, why not?
And we were each supposed to draw the same amount.
Sure, I know.
For 9 years, Mama, it went on like that. Last year, you know, Sam's daughter got married, mm-hmm. So he came to me and he said he needed another $1,000.
Well, sure, she had to get ready her torso.
Mm-hmm. So he drew the $1,000 extra.
Say, a man's daughter gets married, what can he do?
And now comes this year, and I said to Sam, as long as last year you took an extra $1,000, this year, you'll take $1,000 less.
Mm-hmm. What did he say?
What did he say? He said he couldn't do it.
Why did he say he couldn't do it?
What difference does it make what reasons? He said he couldn't do it.
Uh-huh. So about this you're fighting?
Sure, about this we are fighting. If every time he wants $1,000 and takes it, there's the business going to be.
One time ain't every time,
what
Jake?
What if he does it once, Mommy? He can do it again.
But he didn't do it again.
He shouldn't have done it one time.
Well, the time to tell him that was when he done it the first time, not now, a year later.
I told him then, but he said he had to have it.
Well, as long as you gave it to him, why start a fight now?
Why? Do I take $1,000 extra every time I turn around?
Partners shouldn't fight.
Mama, I am not fighting with him. He is fighting with me. Besides, if I came to him and told him I needed $1,000, do you think he'd let me have it?
Did you ask him?
I don't have to ask him, Mama. I know.
Well, what do you need $1,000?
Mama, I don't need it. But if I did need it and I asked him for $1,000, I know he wouldn't give it to me.
So you don't need it, but if you did need it and you asked him and he said no, you'd start a fight. So before anything happens, you're starting a fight just to be on the safe side,
Mama,
huh?
I wouldn't ask him for $1,000 if I starved to death.
If you wouldn't ask him, then he couldn't say no, and then there couldn't be a fight, so what are you fighting about?
But suppose, Mama, suppose I did ask him. There's no use talking. Sam and I are splitting. I could get 1,000,000 partners.
But you couldn't get 1,000,000 Sam.
Yeah, I could get better than Sam.
Sure, but you could get worse than Sam, too. It's better you don't change horses until you've got your bridges crossed. Sam is a good partner. Don't jump out of the frying pan into a kettle of fish.
I don't need partners to take $1,000 every minute.
Don't be so quick. Look before you hesitate.
Yeah, I made up my mind. 2 o'clock today we are meeting, and unless he is willing to take $1,000 less this year, we are splitting up.
Why 2 o'clock today? 10 years you and Sam have been together, and suddenly you can't stand him after 2 o'clock. Couldn't you wait maybe for another week?
Mama, I wouldn't wait an hour.
Let me talk to him, eh?
Talk I don't want. I want $1,000.
Oh,
Good morning, Pa.
Hello.
Good morning,
go back and take off those pajamas.
Well, what's the matter with these pajamas?
In my house, you don't wear pajamas to breakfast. Pajamas you wear to bed.
Well, cheer up, Pop. I won't be in your house much longer.
Huh? Where are you going?
Sally, don't talk foolish. Papa's got enough worries.
I'm not talking foolishness.
Don't worry me this morning. You stay out all night, get up in the middle of the afternoon, and you come down in pajamas. And right away, you start with riddles.
Well, this is no riddle, Pop. After all, Sidney and I are jumping off the bridge together.
You're going swimming?
Yes. Swimming in the sea of matrimony. In other words, I've consented to make Sidney an honest man.
Sidney was stealing something.
Now, wait. I'll start all over again. Sidney and I are going to be married.
You're going to be married?
Sure. You've heard of it. Wedding bells, rice, old shoes. Some of the best people do it.
With Sidney?
Yes, with Sidney.
Sarah, you're not joking.
It's too late for that now. We're taking the fatal step 4 weeks from Monday.
4 weeks from Monday? But why didn't you tell us before?
Well, it just happened last night. That is, Sidney thinks it just happened last night. I made up my mind a couple of months ago. And last night he popped the fatal question, and I had the answer all ready. Now you two figure that out. Meanwhile, I'll change these pajamas. So long.
Becky, what are you crying about, Becky?
Can't I cry a little? Sidney's a fun boy.
Yeah, but what's wrong with Sarah? Even if she does wear pajamas, maybe Sidney likes pajamas.
But you know, Sidney's got no job, huh?
Yeah, he'll get a job. The worst comes to worst, he can go to work for me. That is, as soon as I get my new partner.
What new partner?
What new partner? Did you already forget that Sam and I are meeting at 2 o'clock?
Oh, you mean about the $1,000?
Sure, about the $1,000.
Don't worry, he won't mind if you draw it.
If I draw it?
Sure, you draw it. Sarah's got to get a torso.
Mama, you're right.
Yeah. I can't stand it. I got to call somebody up.
Well, who are you going to call up?
I don't know who to call first. I'd like to call everybody first.
Well, Mama, first you should call Sam. After all, he's entitled to it.
Yeah, dial me up the number, Jake. But when they answer, don't you tell them. I want to tell them myself.
All
huh?
Right, Mama, all right. Just a minute. Hello. Hello. Here it is. Hold the wire. My wife wants to tell you that Sarah's engaged.
Yeah, hello. Hello, yeah. Sam. Is Dora there? Jane, the minute she comes in, tell her to call me. I got swell news. Yeah, Sarah and Sidney are engaged. Yeah, it just happened last night. Yeah, Sidney's a fine boy. Sure, he's a smart fella. Papa said he's going to make him quit his job and go to work for you. And it's elegant. Don't forget to tell Dora to call me, huh? All right. What? Oh, I'll ask him. Jake.
Yeah, what do you want?
Sam says the meeting couldn't be at 2 o'clock. His lawyer's busy and he couldn't make it till 3.
What do we need with lawyers?
Did you forget you and Sam were splitting?
Oh, yeah, for a minute I forgot.
I'll remind him. Hello. Hello, Sam. Papa says never mind the meeting. Yeah. Instead, you and Dora should come to supper tonight. 6 o'clock. Yeah, we're having Sidney. And Papa says you should stop by the office and bring our firm check. Papa's got to have an extra $1,000. He has to buy Sarah some new breakfast pajamas. Oh, Sam, yeah. You do it, huh? Well, all right. We'll see you about 6 o'clock. Yeah, goodbye.
Well, what did he say?
He said he'd bring the check.
Well, what else did he say?
He said never mind the pajamas for Sarah. He'll buy them.